G'day everyone, it's Roy the Boy from Yellaroy here. Unfortunately, coming to you via Federal Express with the sad news that the Bullringer and I are snowed in at the recording studio here in Boston, Massachusetts, good old USA. We're more gutted than fresh roadkill that we can't make the soiree, but I can tell you now, it's a musical and literary triumph. And yous are in for an evening of musical wonder like no other. In addition to their spectacular original songs, you'll be the first to hear the new musical genre, Western Malafonte, in the controversial yet haunting calypso number, O Tambo. You'll also experience the world premiere of the rousing melodic Bastille beat in Could It Be You, Rudy. We haven't closed the program for this evening, and we hope everyone has a great night. Also heard on the AAP Reuters that Norm Fraser and Louis Walsh are attending. Are you two there? Do us a favour and stay off the terps long enough and help run the show this evening. Norm, we'd be very grateful if you could run this evening's program. And Louis, could you make sure everyone gets a program from the package? Thanks, guys. Anyway, gotta go. We're catching up with a few mates of ours from Billow, who work as professors over at MIT. So, it's cheers from Roy the Boy from Yellaroy and the Bullringer. Now, here's a bit of No Mistaken Barkey to start the evening off. Hooroo!
Has passed so quickly, it's now been quite a while since I left my hometown and moved many a mile. And it's a long way from Brizzy to the place that I know best, so it's early in the morning when my trip starts out west. When I reach the Patrick, the journey almost ends. Soon I'll cross the Alice, there's only two more bends till the rows of Peltoffera shimmer into view and welcome me back to the town that I once knew. 'Cause there's no mistaking Barkey, the heart of the Central West, and there's no forsaken city life if you were not impressed by the smell of the Gidgee, an omen of some rain, or a quiet Sunday evening strolling down to meet the train. By sprinklers placed on iron roofs and cooling wide verandas, or going to the footy to cheer the mighty Sanguinas. Now I head down Elm Street where Father gave communion, before some beers at the Globe and a few more at the Union. As I pass the Shire Hall, I can still hear the rock bands play, the rubber band or December sun on the Saturday night cabaret. As I drive down Beach Street, I'm starting to relax till I see ahead the north side, the wrong side of the tracks. And I recall the good old days with a frightening pang, when the lore of the north side was the lore of the gully gang. 'Cause there's no mistaking Barkey, the hub of the Central West, and there's no forsaken coffee clubs if you were not impressed by the smell of the Gidgee, an omen of some rain, or quiet Sunday evening strolling down to meet the train. By sunsets made with golden threads spun from nature's spool, or wicket keeping for the feds when they play state school. So I turn left at the shaky into the main street round the bend, and see they ran out videos where Specie was my friend. And down the road stand Dyack's pub where Froglegs and Madfella would drink their beer and have a bet a few doors from Fred's cellar. As the car rolls down Oak Street, I'll find a place to park it, have a beer with Augie and see if the Globe's still on the market. And that night I will sleep as sound as a newborn lamb, with the night sky to remind me exactly where I am. 'Cause there's no mistaking Barkey, the pulse of the Central West, and there's no forsaken racecourse road if you are not impressed by the smell of the Gidgee, an omen of some rain, or a quiet Sunday evening strolling down to meet the train. By whirly winds in summer that spring up without warning, or parties at the Bullring till the early hours of the morning. The time has come to leave you, but I'll be back again. It's not a question of wanting to, only a matter of when. For I'm not for the coffee clubs, the theater or the arts. I'd rather drink Billy tea and race those billy carts. The highway back to Brizzy seems a very lonely road, not like the one that brought me out to my old abode. And Robert Frost, he would agree, well, so mind unraveled, the joy in part is driving out on the road less traveled. 'Cause there's no mistaking Barkey, the beat of the Central West. There's no forsaken cool sea breeze if you were not impressed by the smell of the Gidgee, or the omen of some rain, or a quiet Sunday evening strolling down to meet the train. By cheering when the weather turns drizzly, cold and bleak, or catching crotchets with some string on the banks of the Lagoon Creek. By sprinklers placed on iron roofs of cooling wide verandas, or going to the footy to cheer the mighty Sanguinas. By sunsets made with golden threads spun from nature's spool, or wicket keeping for the feds when they play state school. By whirlwinds in summer,